Production is the key to economic development of a country. Production can be agricultural, like cultivation of crops, or industrial, like manufacturing of goods. Over 70% of the population in India still lives in villages. People living in villages require various goods and services, many of which are produced locally. Thus, a village is a good place to understand various concepts of production. We have chosen Palampur as a place for study the production. Palampur could be any part of India, from Jammu Kashmir and Kerala, from Gujarat or Assam. This imaginary place called Palampur represents a small place in India. Palampur is pretty well connected by road. A 3 km long road connects small Palampur to a bigger neighboring village called Raiganj. From Raiganj, the small road connects to the nearest place, Shahapur. If you travel the road from Shahapur to Palampur, you find an amazing mix of transport. That is, bullock carts, bogies, motorcycles, jeep, trucks and tractors are all used to transport people and goods on this road. Palampur is a small village inhabited by about 550 families. As in most villages in India, people in Palampur belong to many different castes. The upper caste families in Palampur have pakka houses made up of bricks and cement plasters. If you visit them, you will find that some of these houses are quite large. The Dalit account for about 1/3 of the total population of the Palampur. They live in the corner of the village in small houses made up of mud and dry leaves. Palampur is one of the increasing number of villages in India that have electricity. Most houses in Palampur have electricity connection. Electricity is also used to run two wells in the fields and support local business. You will be surprised to know that in many villages in India, children walk several kilometers to reach their schools. However, children in Palampur are lucky. Palampur has two primary schools and one high school where the children can study. The houses of Palampur also have access to good healthcare services. One government primary healthcare center and a private dispensary take care of the sick patients. So you see, Palampur is a pretty good village who have a good access to road connectivity, transportation, education, electricity and healthcare services. Now let us look at the production activities that the people of Palampur are engaged in. Like most villages in India, agriculture is the main occupation in Palampur. However, all farmers of Palampur does not have same type of jobs. This upper caste families own majority of the cultivated land in Palampur. The other farmers possess small piece of land. And some are landless laborers who work as a laborer in the fields of rich landlords. If you think all the people of Palampur village are farmers, you are not quite correct. Just like other villages in India, people in Palampur are engaged in several non-farming activities like shopkeeping, dairy, small-scale manufacturing, and transport services. All these production activities also require more amount of land and water. Man-made resources like raw material, human efforts, intelligence, and of course, money. In this video, we will see how these resources are used to produce goods and services in Palampur. We use a number of these goods and services every day. All these goods and services are from the food we eat, to the clothes we wear, the technologies we use, and services like bank and the transport we use to travel are available to us through this production. Suppose you have a great idea of making a product or services required by the people. For that, you put your idea into action. You need to consider the factors required for its production. Whether you want to produce a crop, set up an office or building, a factory, you will need some place to do so. Thus, the first requirement for the production is land. Land as a production factor also includes other natural resources like water, forest, and minerals found in the earth's crust. The second requirement for the production is labor or the workforce. These are the people who do different tasks involved in the production. As it is clear from these given pictures, some tasks required hard manual labor, while others required education and technical skills. A production activity needs certain inputs to produce an output to form desired goods and services. The third requirement for the production is the inputs required for the different stages of the production. These inputs are called physical capital or capital. The most important factor here is the entrepreneur, that is the businessman, who will risk his capital, that is money, to start a production activity. Physical capital includes inputs like machinery and tools, money, and raw materials required for the production. Some inputs like the buildings of a factory and the tools and the machinery installed in it can be repeatedly used for production year after year. They do not get used up in production. Such inputs are called fixed capital. Note that the fixed capital can vary from a simple axe tool used by a farmer to a laptop. Inputs like raw material and the money used for buying it, pay electricity bills and wages to the workers, etc., get used up in the production activity. These inputs are called working capital. They are required every time when the production activity takes place. Let us take the example of a potter to understand the difference between physical capital and working capital. The potter uses money to buy clay. He uses this clay to make pots. Money and clay is used in the production of pots. Hence, these are his working capital. However, the potter's wheel can be used again and again to make pots. It is not get used up in the production of pots. Thus, it is his fixed capital. The fourth requirement for the production is human capital. Human capital puts his or her knowledge and efforts to manage with the other factors like land, labor, and physical capital in to start the production of goods or services. Thus, land, labor, physical capital, and human capital are the four requirements for the factors of production activity.